Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. I'm Blacko.
And I'm Mayim Bialik. You might know me from my YouTube channel or as Amy Farrah Fowler from The Big Bang Theory.
As we were hanging out with our friend Sir Clea today, we started talking about why she used to have some trouble back in high school with paying attention in classes and staying organized. Being the amazingly cool person that she is, she told me all about her medical condition that some of my human friends might know about. ADHD. So, Mayim, what is ADHD?
ADHD, or Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, is a brain disorder that's identified by levels of inattention, impulsivity, and hyperactivity that are considered atypical. It's seen as a childhood condition that often continues on into adulthood. ADHD's inattention refers to a person wandering off task, not being very organized, or having a hard time staying focused. Hyperactivity is when a person doesn't seem to stop moving or excessively fidgets or talks. Impulsivity is shown when a person makes quick decisions without thinking them over, especially if the impact of the decision is significant.
But just because you may relate to these traits of ADHD, that doesn't mean you have ADHD yourself. It can be common to have times of inattention, sporadic motor activity, or even times of impulsivity. But for most people with ADHD, these times are far more severe and frequent. For people with ADHD, these symptoms likely interfere with and reduce the quality of their social life or affect their performance at school or the workplace.
It's probably more likely you don't actually have ADHD, since the CDC found in a 2011 study that only around 11% of United States school-aged children were given an ADHD diagnosis by a healthcare provider. Interestingly enough, they also found that the rate of ADHD diagnosis was about double for high school boys as it was for high school girls. Keep in mind, though, these are rates of people being professionally diagnosed, which may or may not be the same as occurrences of ADHD. It's possible for people to suffer from ADHD, especially with milder cases, and not be properly diagnosed.
While there is no cure, treatments like medication and psychotherapy can help reduce the symptoms of ADHD and improve a person's life. Medication for ADHD is usually in the form of a stimulant, which works by increasing chemicals in the brain, like dopamine, that aid in thinking and staying focused. Psychotherapy is often in the form of behavior therapy, and can help in changing a person's behavior. This is done in ways such as helping a person finish their work, organize tasks, or cope with emotional situations. Both of these types of treatment combined were how my friend Sir Clea was able to overcome her condition and manage it the best she can. She's just great, you know? Anyway.
A recent study also found that exercise might be able to help with ADHD symptoms too. Looking at younger children, researchers found that regular bouts of 30-minute exercise sessions led to improved attention and mood in the participants. Exercise might not be a powerful enough treatment to use on ADHD all by itself, but it seems like it can be helpful when used with other methods. And since the CDC reports exercise can do wonders, such as help control your weight, improve your mood, reduce the risk of some cancers, and increase your bone and muscle strength, it's probably a good idea to get moving anyway.
So have you or anyone you know been diagnosed with ADHD? If you're comfortable with it, share your experience and what's helped the most in the comment section below.
Thanks everybody for watching. I'm a huge fan of Life Noggin, and if you're interested in watching more of my videos, I have a channel here on YouTube, and I recently discussed how dope DNA is. Check it out. Inside every single cell of our bodies, there's a core called the nucleus, and inside of that core is DNA. DNA is a kind of code, and amino acids are the output of that code, and they determine your genetic makeup.
My name is Blacko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.